In this video, we're going to cover this rear sump oil pan kit offered by Stangaholics. In this kit, you will get the rear sump 5-quart oil pan, the one-piece oil pan gasket, a choice of dipstick, the pickup tube, and attaching hardware for the pickup tube. The pan included in this kit is a rear sump pan that's got a 5-quart capacity with a stock outside appearance. As you can see, the big sump is in the rear, like Fox Body Mustangs have stock, with a smaller sump in the front. It does feature a drain at the rear sump and also has another drain at the smaller front sump here. Another feature to point out on this pan is that it has a provision on the side in the rear deep sump of the pan. So what this will do is it'll allow you to either, you can leave this set screw in it to block it off if you're not going to use it, if you have a later model 302 block where the dipstick will go pass through the block into the rear sump of the pan. However, if you have a classic Mustang utilizing like a Mustang II type of front suspension that has a rack and pinion mounted in the front that's going to require this type of pan, and you've got the 60s era 289 or 302 motor, then you can use this provision on the side of the pan to then run your dipstick down through the provision and into the deep sump of the pan. And that is because the earlier 289 or 302 motors does not have a provision in the rear on the block. Instead, the stock placement is in the front of the motor for the dipstick. Moving to the inside of this pan, you can see how well it's made, and it does have baffling here in the rear to control the oil to help keep it right where the pickup inlet will be. Also has a crank scraper as well, which is nice. And then as you can see, the inside right here where that passes through for the provision for the dipstick if used. Now moving to the gasket included with the kit. It's a premium USA made one piece gasket. And this is important because in this type of a pan, you should not use a 4-piece gasket that's gonna have the separate pieces here, then separate pieces here in the front and back. Instead, you want it to be a 1-piece, just like this one, because it'll seal properly with this pan design, the flange. Another important thing to point out too, it helps to lay it nicely on the flange, is it has a metal core in it, so it gives it a little bit of rigidity. Also helps it to lay nice and flat on the flange there for an excellent seal at all corners and along all sides. Along with the rest of the components in the kit, as you can see, we have a TIG welded 3-quarter diameter, it's kind of like a stock style pickup tube, which is USA made, and it's of excellent quality. Like I said, just a stock style TIG welded pickup. And then along with that, we have your pickup stud to mount it to the pump. And this pickup here will work with most standard volume and high volume pumps. The part number for those pumps will be in the description for this kit. Moving along, we have in this kit your choice of dipsticks. So we have the standard dipstick, which just has this straight metal sheath on it and kind of your typical handle. And then this option, which is going to be a stainless steel sheath with a really nice polished billet aluminum handle. And this, and then it also has a bracket right there too to mount it securely. So we're going to now go over the differences between these two dipsticks when mounting them to the pan. Going over the two options on the dipsticks that we have. So again, with this being the basic one with your straight sheath on it. And so this would just go right into the pan, of course, and then thread in. It's a 1/4-inch MPT fitting. Both of these are, of course, so it would just thread right into this. But with this one though, you have to remember that you're going to have to bend it then to try to get it to clear headers. Long tube headers can be a little bit of an issue sometimes with this. Shorty headers can be easier to work with this type of a tube. So keep that in mind. This is a less expensive option, but it can be a little bit frustrating when trying to work it around headers, especially long tube headers. Now the other option, which we really like, again, is this stainless steel flexible dipstick. And so that one, of course, is just gonna go right in and thread into the same fitting. What's nice about this one, though, as you can see, is it's going to be able to easily flex wherever you need it to around to clear headers or other components that might be in the way. Also, this has a set screw on it here, so if you need to trim the length of it to get the correct reading on your pan, then you can trim the length by taking the handle off and then trimming the top of the dipstick to the appropriate length. And then of course you would also have to trim this stainless steel sheath as well, which isn't a big deal. So those are the two options on dipsticks. Once again, we prefer this braided stainless steel one. So just to review, this rear sump oil pan kit is a great option for the first gen classic Mustang that has a Mustang II style front suspension installed on it, that has a rack that mounts in the front of the cross member. So that's why you have the rear sump pan for good clearances. It also provides good ground clearance. It's a stock dimensions as a Fox body pan. It's not too wide, doesn't have a T in the rear or anything for long tube header clearance issues. It's a 5-quart capacity, so it's just a really great option for either the Fox body Mustang, the drag racer that needs a stock appearing oil pan, or just a replacement oil pan for a Fox body car, or again, like I said, for the classic Mustang using a Mustang II front mounted rack suspension system. So we hope this video was informative and helpful, and thank you very much for watching.